Hello children, today in science we are going to learn about sound and noise. Children, from the moment we wake up in the morning till the time we go to sleep, we hear a large number of different sounds throughout the day. Every object around us makes a distinct sound. Some of these sounds make us feel happy and relaxed, whereas others may hurt our ears if we listen to them for too long. Now children, some of the sounds that we hear in our daily routine are tick-tock sound of a clock, musical sound of a doorbell, creaking sound of an old door, hissing sound of a kettle, and whistling sound of a pressure cooker. All living beings make different sounds. Human beings mostly use the sound of their voices when speaking to each other. When we visit a crowded market, a playground, or a shopping mall, we hear so many different sounds. We can hear announcements being made over loudspeakers, people talking to each other, children shouting and running around, and many more such sounds. We can easily recognize an animal or a bird by the type of sounds they make. Some animals and bird sounds that we or a bird may by the type of sound it makes. Some animals and bird sounds that we are familiar with include roaring of a tiger or a lion, chattering of monkeys, howling of wolves, screeching of parrots, chirping of sparrows, cooing of pigeons, and barking of dogs. So all these are the different sounds that we hear and we know. Now children, some of the sounds are the warning sounds. Warning sounds are loud sounds that are used to warn people about a danger or an emergency. These warning sounds are important as they alert the people to either get out of or stay away from a place or a situation that may put their lives in danger. And what are these sounds, children? These sounds, warning sounds, are sounds made by a fire alarm, sound of a police siren, ambulance siren, fire engine siren. So all of these are warning sounds. Now children, as I've told you earlier also, that some sounds are pleasant and some sounds are unpleasant. Now, sounds that can be pleasant or unpleasant, okay? So, the sounds that we enjoy listening to, like we enjoy listening to music. So, it is a pleasant sound. Sound made by waves on a beach. Then, the sound of the gentle breeze. Sound of the gently falling rain. And the gentle chirping of the birds. So, all of these are pleasant sounds. And some of the sounds, children, that we don't feel like listening, we don't like to listen at all, okay, and that irritate us, are unpleasant sounds. What can these sounds be, children, that are unpleasant, we don't like them? These sounds are honking of vehicles, loud explosions, loud sounds made by aircrafts while taking off or landing, noise from factories and generators, and loud music. So all these sounds are unpleasant sounds. A loud and unpleasant sound that can cause physical and mental disturbance is called noise. Okay? Loud noise or sounds disturbs our comfort level. Excessive and continuous noise is called noise pollution. All right, children? So now, children, the harmful effects of the noise pollution are dizziness, headache and earache, tiredness and stress, loss of sleep and loss of concentration, hypertension, and even permanent loss of hearing. Noise pollution can cause hearing loss and irritability in animals too. All right, children? So now we know the reasons, the causes, and what are the effects of noise pollution. Now, children, how can we reduce the noise pollution? Okay, now I'm going to tell you how we can reduce this noise pollution. We can reduce noise pollution by avoiding loudspeakers for too long and too loudly. Get electrical appliances checked regularly to reduce the sound produced by them. Traffic should be regulated to avoid noise from vehicles, okay? And unnecessary honking should be controlled, especially in the residential areas near schools and hospitals, all right? Use heavy carpets and curtains at home because they also absorb the noise that is coming from outside. Plant trees in the neighborhood. Trees and plants also absorb noise. And we should avoid watching television and listening to radio at a high volume. So children, I think all the points are clear to you now. So we should take the following preventions and measures to save ourselves from noise pollution. Thank you.